Namaste viewers, welcome to Gnana Degula channel. We will see what is Bhasma, the sacred ash of Bhasma. We will see the ritual and spiritual part of this Bhasma. In the middle of the Shaiva tradition, Bhasma, Vibhuti is very much important. It has got a very revered place. It is not just merely ash, it is more than ash. It's a very vital element of daily worship and it is an essential part of the spiritual practice. The worship of Lord Shiva, who is the supreme deity in the Shaiva sector, you cannot commence it without application of Bhasma. One has to wear Bhasma, only thereafter he has to perform the puja. Now, what is Bhasma? The ash left over burning any object can call be Bhasma. See, what is Bhasma means? It is, what do you call, the ash. Whatever is left over after an object is burnt completely is Bhasma. But in reality, Bhasma is something more sacred, more spiritual, more, it has got more relevance. The true Bhasma, the actual Bhasma, comes from the burning of samits. That means samit means sacrificial firewood. We use it for homa, homagni and then yajna. Along with ghee, that is clarified butter. This, whatever we put samits in the sacrificial fire, the ultimate, after everything is burnt, you know, whatever is left, that is called as, the holy ash is called as Bhasma. It carries with it some kind of a divine blessing. Sometimes, as a part of ritual, the idol of the deity is Bhasma is poured over it, it is bathed with Bhasma. So when you bath the linga or the murti with Bhasma, it is believed this, the ash absorbs the divine energy from the deity, it becomes more powerful. The ash now imbued with the deity's grace is considered to be the correct and the true Bhasma, capable of purifying and protecting the devotee. Now, the meaning of Bhasma is, Bha means elimination, Bhati, that means, Sma means remembrance, Smarane, like this, you know. So when applied, Bhasma is believed to help eliminate negative qualities or demerits within us while simultaneously reminding us of the God. This is the aspect of, this is the result of applying Bhasma. It purifies the soul as well as the body. And it ensures that the devotees, they stay on the path of righteousness and spiritual remembrance. So now Bhasma is also known by Raksha, Vibhuti, Rakha, all those kinds of different names are there. How to apply Bhasma? There is a procedure for that. Now, where should this Bhasma be applied? Sri Guru Charita says Bhasma should be applied while reciting the mantras, which charge the ash with divine energy. Whenever you apply, you put Bhasma, you put it on the palm, you hear, then mix it with little water so that it becomes a paste like thing. Agni Riti Mantra, Vayu Riti Mantra, like this you utter the mantras, then apply it on the forehead. As these sacred words are uttered, the Bhasma is made holier. The Bhasma becomes more purified. The ash is then rubbed between the thumb and forefinger, like this, and applied to the, like this, and applied to the forehead while chanting the Triambaka mantra. Triambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukam Yobandhanar Mutyur Mamakshinatat. This is one mantra which should be uttered. Then other mantras guide the application of Bhasma to different parts of the body, such as arms, chest, then thighs, leg, and this is a kind of a divine shield around the devotee. For some people, they may not know these mantras. Simply apply the Bhasma with the bhava, spiritual emotion. Om Namah Shivaya, like this, you know. You can say Om Namah Shivaya and then apply the Bhasma. Pure intention and faith, it will amplify its effects, filling the devotee with divine protection and energy. This is more important. Then in the Rigveda, the ritual says, Brahma Karma, Rigvedic Brahma Karma. The practice begins with Achmanya, just sipping water. Then after you sip the water, chant the names of Vishnu. Then Pranayama. Pranayama is breath control. Control your breath, inhale and then exhale slowly. Then you chant the mantra Manasto Ketanaya Mana Ayushya Manogo. This mantra is there. After you chant this mantra, apply on the specific parts of the body in a very precise manner. This ritual aims to purify the body, soul, allowing the devotee to connect with the divine. This is the Rigvedic ritual part. Then you have this Tripundra symbol. Tripundra means three parallelly drawn like this. These three horizontal strips of Bhasma applied across the forehead, this symbolizes the destruction of the three impurities of mind. That is ego, ignorance and attachment. All these three are bound, that bind the soul, you know. So this impurities, you know, it will remove. So here also, the Bhasma is touched with the right hand, charged with seven mantras. Om Agni Riti Mantra, Vayu Riti Mantra, Yoma Iti Mantra, all these mantras, and then applied on the forehead. Now, Bhasma has got a purifying power. Ultimately, the significance of Bhasma is deeply spiritual. It is a reminder of the impermanence of the physical world and the eternal nature of the soul. When we apply Bhasma, we acknowledge the sacred cycle of creation and destruction, understanding that everything, whether elements, gods, humans, everything will return to one day or the other to ashes. They all burn out. They all, like all the elements, go away and then ultimately the ash remains. It is this realization that helps devotees shed their ego and attachments, focusing on spiritual purity. So, in every strip, every of the Bhasma, In every ritual chant, there is a call to connect with the divine. Bhasma purifies, protects and transforms the soul, guiding the devotee closer to Lord Shiva's infinite grace. Yes, with this explanation on the Bhasma, further explanation on the Bhasma, we conclude this episode. We request you to please like, share and then subscribe to our channel. Thank you.